There we go. Guys, thanks for joining a special broadcast here this evening. Tonight, we have on the broadcast, and I'm on your broadcast, Jadira O'Farrell. Now, I don't know who's interviewing who or who shows who, but we have been talking for a couple of months about politics and about interviewing each other. Somehow we met through the Facebooks. We each do some sort of podcast, and we just started messaging each other about doing a potential collaboration. And you do a very super serious. I do some very not serious. It's a bunch of nonsense about high school stories. And then I've got one that's about Bible study, sermons, study. And then you do something ultra serious. You are a political activist and you are Puerto Rican. And today's hot topic is none other than what was said at the Madison Square Garden Trump rally. We're going to talk about that real quick. But first, Jadira, welcome. Tell us who you are and what your role is as a political activist.
Hello, my name is Jadira O'Farrell. I live in Georgia. I've been living in Georgia for 8 years, but I am activist. We are an activist, all the Puerto Ricans, about statehood, Puerto Rico statehood. But it moved forward, and I'm Republican. I've always been Republican. Puerto Rico is a very conservative place. So I moved forward, and now I work with the Republicans as well. I've been in the United Nations 3 times talking about Puerto Rico statehood, and we want to decolonize Puerto Rico. That is what I have a group of activists around all United States. And that's what I do. I do podcasts. I talk to people. I visit Washington, D.C. I have conversation with senators, representatives. It's a very serious job, but I love it. I'm very passionate about it.
Easily the most famous person that I've had on my podcast. The rest of these people on my podcast are these clowns that I went to high school with. So you are already the most educated and cultured and popular person that we've had here. So welcome. Thanks for bringing some culture to the place here. So first question. Okay. So Trump rally yesterday at Madison Square Garden, it sold out, I think within hours or within a couple of days. And they had different speakers like you would see at any other rally that they would have, either for the Democrats. They've had, Democrats have had Beyonce, former President Obama and his wife, Michelle. They've had some other, they've had a lot of more music and celebrity people. And President Trump had, I seen Hulk Hogan on there. And he had a couple of other people. He had Elon Musk on there and a couple of other news guys. And then he had this comedian named Tony Hinchcliffe. Who is Tony Hinchcliffe? I didn't know he was a comedian. And I didn't know he had said anything stupid until late last night. I was about to go to bed and I'm scrolling down. And I seen one of my Hispanic friends that was a pastor. And he says, this guy made a stupid joke at the Trump rally. And I was like, oh God, what happened now? Who said what? Because we're getting super close to the election and both parties are really trying to be very careful and not say anything that's going to cost them the election, because it is pretty close. According to a lot of polls, Trump may be inching above, but, so I was like, oh man, who said what? And in general, whether you're liberal or Democrat or Republican, you don't want anything said that is inappropriate or hurtful to any group of people, even though unfortunately that does happen on both sides. What I was saying is that I did not know this guy was a comedian. I've seen him on a couple of podcasts interviewing different people, and he knows a lot about wrestling, you know, like the World Wrestling Federation. So I don't know why they added him on as a comedian, but he said something pretty stupid and pretty out of pocket about the Puerto Rican people. So Jadira, what's your take on it?
The joke was really, really bad joke, especially for us Puerto Ricans. We Puerto Ricans are very proud, and we don't like anybody outside Puerto Rico to make jokes about Puerto Rico. It's mostly like the Texans, the people from Texas, they don't like other people making fun of them because they are proud. And that is happening with us, which is really strange, is that he makes those jokes in New York. New York is the second state with the biggest concentration of Puerto Ricans right now. So why you make a joke like that in New York when Trump is looking forward for that vote in New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Florida, Texas? I don't know. It was really strange for me. I was angry, obviously, because not just I don't like the joke. It was because it was a setback with the Puerto Ricans voting for Trump. I already voted. For me, I really don't care about a comedian saying whatever he was saying, because I know my people. I know the Republican Party. I've been with the Republican Party, and I know that is not the sentiment of Donald Trump or anybody in the campaign. So I don't know why they bring this guy with this stupid comments. I'm not even gonna say racist, because it's not even that. He wasn't that good to make a joke, a racist joke. It wasn't good.
No, and I watched the whole thing, you know, just to get context, and the whole. He reminded me of me, shamedly, a guy who thinks he's kind of funny sometimes, but not, and says stuff that after the fact is, wow, man, why did I say something so stupid? And so he's probably had a lot of people tell him he's funny, and just enough people, so he started his own podcast and did stand up. He's probably maybe a decent person. I don't know him. I really don't know him. But I know that the entire comedic bit wasn't really that funny. And like you said, you felt like it set back the Puerto Ricans as far as having trust in the Republican Party or Donald Trump.
Yes. And that is our biggest problem, because we have in Pennsylvania 300,000 Puerto Ricans. And that is a battleground state. Mm-hmm. Here in Georgia, there is 120,000 Puerto Ricans. It's a lot of people. And in Florida, we have millions of Puerto Ricans. We are talking about a red state. You know, a red state that you are making remarks that they are not good, they are not beautiful, and they are very offensive about the island that we already have problems talking about the colonization of Puerto Rico. And they say that is a garbage floating island. So we really are that bad for him. He really believes that, or because to make a joke, you have to have something that you took or you were talking about to say something like that. We are American citizens. So all the people who live in Puerto Rico right now, 3.2 million of Puerto Ricans, they are American citizens, and they are calling them garbage. That is what it sound. That is the sound of it. And that is why the people are very, not angry, but not happy either.
Yeah, I don't blame them. And I thought his whole bit was not funny. Even when he was making fun of people that we may not particularly vote for, I thought all of it was kind of not funny and kind of without class. I don't watch the Democratic rallies. So maybe they have the same type of counterpart where they make fun of Trump and make fun of his kids, or I think they did that anyway, but years ago. But anyway, I don't really think that holds a place anymore. And so I was very surprised to see that being part of the show. I mean, you can have Rambo and Hulk Hogan and the My Pillow guy get up there and some other just average people, you know, veterans. Let's hear some veterans. I don't know how that cat got up there, and I don't know how, and I don't believe that he showed them his jokes and they said, oh yeah, that's hilarious. Yeah, please share that. So anyway, so what would you say moving forward as a woman and as a Puerto Rican, what would you say to the Puerto Rican folks that are feeling the way they're feeling about it? Probably not too good. What would you say?
Obviously, me as a Puerto Rican, it was offensive, but I have to move forward. And that is a comedian. I'm not going to take it. Sometimes you have not to take it personal. It was a bad joke again, but it was something that he thinks. I don't believe like I told you that the Republican Party feel that way. We have senators and representatives calling that in Twitter since yesterday. Even the campaign say that it wasn't what Trump feel or the campaign feel about the Puerto Ricans. And I'm, as a woman, believe me, I'm more angry at Kamala when it took her like an hour to talk about how important is the Puerto Rican people, when in the whole campaign, she never addressed the Puerto Ricans at all. Yesterday, she remembered that there is an island there in the Caribbean, and she has to address the issue, offering economic help. That is not the way you address the problem. We're having a problem about being a colony, the oldest colony in the world, 126 years. And she didn't talk about that. So only is money, and obviously her campaign is about giving money to the people. I don't know where the money's coming, but she wants to give money to the people, and about abortion. And we still don't have anything important or anything that tells me how she's gonna run the nation. So I'm not gonna change. Because of that, I'm gonna keep going as a Republican. I'm very conservative. I believe in everything that the Republican Party stand up for. So I'm not gonna change. And believe me, I've been talking this to other people, and they feel the same way. But we still need that reassurance from the Republican Party that everything is going to be better. Everything, that is not the real thing. I will love if Trump says something after he's been talking to Puerto Ricans.
Because I'm sure Trump will say something about it, because, I mean, they kind of have already with some releases saying those jokes do not represent what we're about. And you said that he may be doing a press conference tomorrow. So yes, maybe that will come up or something. we're going to end this because we wanted to keep it short and just to this point. And hopefully a lot more people will watch it. And I think my takeaway is this guy does, that joke does not represent Donald Trump or the Republican Party. And for the record, there's been some very bizarre things that have, what's his name? Is it Tom Waltz? Like when he said he's friends with school shooters. I know, guys, come on. I know what that guy meant. He is not really friends with school shooters, okay? And so when you get sometimes behind the microphone and you're in front of thousands of people, you say some stupid things and you don't know what you're saying. And so I think that was the case here, but we just want to make it clear because there are a lot of Puerto Ricans, as you said, and they are very passionate about their country and their culture. And so just to ignore that, like it will go away tomorrow, like most things in the media, they have a shelf life of 24 hours. And then the next day, somebody else did something crazy or said something dumb or what have you. But I'm grateful for the opportunity for us to finally collaborate on something real quick. Any final thoughts for the people watching? And be sure to tell them what your dog's name is, you said earlier.
My dog?
Yeah.
My dog name is J-Lo. But what I'm going to say, you know, don't let this stop you. I believe United States is more important than a comedian. This is the time to go and vote because we cannot take 3 or 4 years of what we're having for 3.5 years. Remember, Kamala is a person that has been the vice president of the United States that says that Biden was in the better shape of his life. And 2 weeks after that, he wasn't able to run for president. So we are talking about the not only Kamala, but the media and the Democrat Party completely. They lied to us for 3.5 years about Biden. So do we really gonna give them the opportunity to keep lying? Mm-hmm. But I don't believe one thing about the Democrats. The Democrats has been wandering around with Puerto Rico for too long. Me as a Puerto Rican, for me, that is more important than a bad joke.
Right. All right, Mr. Jarrett, well said. Thanks for joining the special broadcast tonight. And we'll see you guys on the next event. You know, for fun, we may do a couple more of these as they get closer to the election. Yeah, we'll do that. All right. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. Have a great night.
Good night.